Today I'm going to be showing you how I'm teaching the kiddos to do with regrouping with subtraction. Let's say that we had a problem something like 112 minus 86. What I'm going to ask them to do is to break down each of these numbers into their individual place values. You can kind of think of it as the hundreds, the tens, and the ones. So I'm going to take 100 from here minus 0. Because there's no hundreds in this problem. 100 minus 0. Then I'm going to write the tens before I ever solve this. 10 minus 80. And even though this looks like a big no-no, I tell the kiddos to wait for it, and that's okay. Right now they just write 10 minus 80. And the big thing that I want to make sure that they don't do is accidentally flip it and take 80 minus 10, because it's really supposed to be this 10 minus 80. Then it's going to be 2 minus 6. So the first thing they've done is to set up their problem. Now they're going to subtract. 100 minus 0 equals 100. 10 minus 80. And because they've been taught like red flags, like, oh wait, I'm not supposed to do that, they're going to know that they have to do something special. So because of the way that I've taught them the math, they know that I'm going to take away 100 here, and this would leave 0, and I'm going to send it over here. So now I have 110 minus 80, and I teach them to think of that as 11 tens minus 8 tens. 11 minus 8 is 3 tens. They have 2 minus 6, and they know that because of those red flags, I'm not supposed to do that, so they know they're going to take a 10 from here. That leaves 20 left. And they're going to send it here. 12 minus 6. That equals 6. And so their answer is 26. And that's how they've been doing their regrouping.